Hello, friends. My name's Alissa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And I want to welcome you to our celebration of National Engineers Week. Engineers are people who use stuff to build stuff that does stuff. You can look it up in the dictionary and you'll find a much more complicated explanation, but we at the Children's Museum like that one. You'll also need to explore, create, test, and most importantly, try again. For today's engineering activity, we are going to explore batteries and bulbs. Let's get ready. Today we'll be exploring circuits. And the word circuit sounds like the word circle. And that's a good thing to remember, because a circuit is a circle of unbroken electricity. When you plug in a lamp, it looks like everything's just going in one direction. But if you open up that wire, you'll see that there's two lines going back and forth from the power source to the bulb. The power source has a positive and a negative end, running back and forth between the power and the bulb. When the light is switched on, the electricity goes back and forth between the bulb and the power source in a circle. When the switch is turned off, the circle is broken and the bulb is not turned on. Batteries have a positive end and a negative end. But if they're not labeled, you just need to remember that the positive end has the little button poking out. To connect your bulb to the battery, you need to remember to make a circle between the positive, the negative, and the bulb. Here's the things you'll need to explore your circuits. First, you'll need a power source, like this battery. Then, you'll need something for your power source to power up. We'll be using Christmas tree lights. And don't worry, I'll show you how to get them like this. Then, it's handy to have some of these. This is called an alligator clip. You can see how the clip part kind of looks like an alligator's mouth. But if you don't have any of those, don't worry. You can just use pieces of wire, and I'll show you how you can acquire those too. And it might be handy to have some masking tape. Here's how you prep your Christmas lights. Now, this is a great time of year to get Christmas lights because a lot of stores still have a lot of them and they don't really want them anymore because Christmas is over. So they're selling them for really cheap. So get a hold of some Christmas lights. It's also useful to have a wire cutter and a wire stripper. If you don't have this tool, you can use scissors and an Xacto knife. Either way, you definitely want a grown-up to help you with this part. So what you'll do is cut off a length of your Christmas tree lights. And you're going to cut every other light. So I'm going to undo the wires. And I'm going to cut here. So now I have a nice long length of wire to use. This one, unfortunately, will just have to go in the trash. Then we cut the next one. Keep cutting for as many lights as you want to play with. I suggest at least two. Then, you'll need to strip the ends of the wire. You can see the metal inside the plastic coating, and that's what the electricity is going to travel through. So you use your wire stripper to strip off the very end. I like to twist it up so it doesn't get all tangled in itself. Just makes things a little neater and easier to work with. You might also need some lengths of just plain wire. And fortunately, you've got it right here in your Christmas lights. So this is just some plain wire, and we're going to do the same thing. Now the wire is useful because if you're using Christmas lights that have been cut a little shorter, or really anytime you're working with anything and you need to get some extra length, you can just twist your wires together. And there you are. So use your Christmas lights and your wires and your battery to try our challenges. If you have alligator clips, you can just clip them on to the bare wire like this. Your first challenge is to take the battery and the bulb, and that's it, and see if you can get the bulb to light up. There. I've got my bulb lit. Now, I'm intentionally not showing you how I've got it connected to the battery, because I want you to figure it out. Now don't worry, this battery is not strong enough to hurt you in any way. So don't worry about electrocuting yourself. It won't happen. Just play around and see if you can get your bulb to light. And then take on challenge number two. Now that you've got the hang of getting one bulb lit on one battery, what should we try next? What if you want your bulb to be brighter? You need more power, so you might need more batteries. How do you connect your bulb to the batteries? Or maybe you want to light up more than one bulb. How can you do that? Now let's try exploring what kinds of materials will let electricity pass through them. The word we use for that is conduct. We say that these things conduct electricity, or that they are conductive. So for this last experiment, go around your home and just gather up any kind of random things you can find. We're going to make a circuit and plug those objects into the circuit and see what conducts electricity and what doesn't. You're also going to make some predictions before you start. Which materials do you think will conduct electricity, and which materials do you think will not? So like I said, for this challenge, just gather up all kinds of crazy stuff from around your home. See some of the things I've got here. I've got rubber band, a wooden spoon, old harmonica, scissors, a plastic fork, straw, key, and a chopstick. Let's get rid of all of those for the moment and just choose one of them. How about the paperclip? So what you're going to do is get your bulb lit. There we go. Then disconnect your circuit. Not surprisingly, the bulb goes out. We're going to try putting something in the circuit here to see if it will turn the light back on, to see if this is conductive. I'm going to connect it to my alligator clip, touch it to my wire, and the light goes on. So now I know that a paperclip will conduct electricity. Now let's try the rubber band. It's kind of long and skinny like a wire. That might work. What do you think? Touch it to my wire. Huh. Nothing. Let me make sure my connections are all good here. That's connected. That's connected. All right. There we go. Nothing. Well, I guess a rubber band will not conduct electricity. I'll put that over on this side. Well, I'm not going to go through all of my objects, but I do want you to try and see if you can figure out if there's a pattern. What sorts of objects will conduct electricity, and what sorts of objects will not? Well, thanks for joining me today to explore batteries and bulbs. Don't forget to keep checking back here on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram for more engineering activities that you can try. Maybe you'll get some really bright ideas of your own. Thanks for joining me, and see you next time. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to follow us on social media and subscribe to us on YouTube. Just press the big red button.